going to be in that agreement because it's been negotiated under a cloak of secrecy. Now, I should say we're not against trade agreements per se. Trade agreements can be good for the country, they can be good for the economy, they can present challenges for the economy as well, but they can be good for the trade that we do and the exports that we manage to sell. So we're not against trade agreements, but we have two particular concerns about what could be in this trade agreement, and I stress could because we don't know, and you know, to be fair, the UK government is telling us we don't need to worry about this, but I've learned from experience that we should probably wait and see how it transpires before we believe those assurances. But the two concerns we've got are this. Firstly, there is a significant concern that this agreement will effectively open up our public services and our NHS in particular to privatisation. Now, I will fight the privatisation of our NHS with every breath I have in my body. So we will oppose that as strongly. Trade agreement might give companies, big corporations, the power if a government, a national government, was to change a policy or change the law in a way that the corporation thought damaged their economic interests, they would have the right to take the government to court. Now, I don't think that is the kind of thing we should be putting into these trade agreements. So these are the two concerns we have. We don't have the power over this. We're not, unfortunately, an independent country, but we will argue as strongly as we can that these two concerns shouldn't come to pass, and that any trade agreement that does transpire is one that is in our interest, not against the interests of the things that we hold dear. So that's, I think, all three questions. Can I just say, Dundee, you've been a fantastic audience.